breastfeeding livestock currently. We're pulling out the livestock as many as we can. And the problem is the people. You know, I understand that, and that is something that I would have to face, but I have to apologize to these buildings. Please don't order the against this order to call me from Secretary Ani. I'm not scholar.
Mayor, Mayor, I'm looking at the building of the Lindos, malapit po sa malabi sa pinagkakatayan yung slaughterhouse. Ayaw doon na natin yung mga alaga nila.
Sino po ang mayor?
May mga neighbor po kami na gusto raw nila sa bahay pa rin sila ng pagkakatayan.
It's not dangerous
home. No.
It's not practical. This is about saving lives. And kung ipapalit ito ko yung mga livestock, ganun din ang mangyayari, pinapahaba ng buhay. Unlike kung dito, i-relocate na naman doon, hindi naman necessarily nakakatayan, no? Unless binigay po sa kanila ng government. And I've already said more than once that the government is willing to buy the livestock that is cleared by our city bank that is good for consumption. And that is in the
earlier, we interviewed one of the residents na siya'y nag-review ng mga fighting pack.
Yes.
Sabi niya na mag-review siya ng 27 fighting packs. Ano po sa peers ng mga nila na hindi sila papalit, may mga nakakawal.
See, that's the reason why we don't want to have the window in the first place, because we want to make sure that all no civilians will be inside because of this instance that we're trying to avoid. But they insisted on having the window, and of course there are repercussions in this request of theirs. Now that they know the repercussions of which, I think it's time that they should agree that the window time is a bad idea for everyone else who lives in the 40 kilometer wages. Because during the lockdown, the previous lockdown that we enforced, we were doing the sweep and looking and searching for all these other civilians who are hiding, you know, hiding inside 40 kilometer ranges. We had some incidences that we were chasing after them, and they were like hiding, and we lost track of them. So, meron talaga po mga maghanap. Pero during now, we had a previous lockdown, there was no window. Wala po masyadong nangyayari ng maghanap. Kasi hindi rin naman sila mga. Pero now na nag-request sila ng window, nung pinagbigyan natin ng mga kubayan, habang hinahamak po kami ng mga livestock, eh, nagkaroon po ng increase of possibilities and anomalies, even incidences ng mga nakakaw.
Mayor,
yung
process
ng
survey.
Yes,
Mayor, isa pa ko sila, may nakausap naman kami, actually, hindi dito sa lugar, pero like what you said, meron mga hiding ng mga residents. Paano po, papagang sabi po nung iba, pag daw nagkaroon ng total lockdown, meaning they can't go inside na, magtatago na lang talaga sila, and hindi sila lalabas.
That's why we have the informant, our police officers, and military armies right here as well. And the Coast Guards are waiting as well to actually monitor those who are very insistent and stubborn to even stay. We have our operations that we need to finalize it today, and the lockdown must be decided as we can.
Lastly, Mayor, yung window hour tomorrow, mag-ilag pa rin o wala?
No. After what happened this noon, pagputok po ng bulkan, kahit kung mamaya, I would discourage it.
So, 3 p.m. wala na po?
I would discourage 3 p.m. To the lockdown. Kasi katulad mo niyan, tatlong traders na po yung officer namin kanina na active. That's very, very dangerous po. Ayaw na po namin na may peligro pa kahit mga bukod sa kababayan po natin, yung mga officers po natin, mga men.
Thank you, Mayor. Mayor, magandang siya ng footage.
Thanks.